this church all the time, and I'd never been to church. I'd never heard of God. I was 14, like I said, and there'd be several times where I would be skating out there, and in between the buildings there are these two these little rooms, right? And so in one specific one, I would skateboard in there all the time, and it had a little box kind of like this. It was a bench. It was made out of brick. It was to sit on, but if you're a skateboarder and you're 14, it's great to do 50-50 grinds on and nose stalls and stuff like that. And it's super loud because it's all concrete, right? And there'd be several times where this lady would come out the side door there, and she would say, "Hey, either come inside or leave because we're trying to have service." I'm like, "Okay." And so I would skate off mad, of course. And I was like, whatever service is, big deal. And one day I was out there and I was skateboarding. This kid walks up. I was learning heel flips at the time. And heel flips, if you land on the board wrong, it could be detrimental to everything. And this kid's like, "Can I see your board?" I'm like, "Sure." So he does a heel flip and he lands it first try. And I'm like, "Dude, that was a heel flip." He's like, "Yeah." I had been trying to learn heel flips for 3 months straight, right? And I had the battle wounds to prove it. And I'm like, "How long did it take you to learn that?" And he's like, "Oh, about 2 weeks." I'm like, "That's cool." I wasn't going to tell him that I have been beating myself to death with a skateboard for 3 months. And he's like, "We're having some junk food inside if you're interested." And I said, "Let's do it." I walk in this big white building that I'd also, I had skateboarded on their wooden wheelchair ramps a lot. It was like, and then you had to turn before you flipped over the railing at the bottom or whatever. Anyway, I walk into this fellowship hall is what they called it. And there's more food than I'd ever seen in my life. It's during a potluck dinner, and I'm like, "What is this?" It's sweet, whatever it is. And so I was there that night, and I ate as much as I possibly could. Not as much as I had last night. I had, what is it called, Son of Thurman? I ate a burger there. I haven't eaten since. It's not true. It's a barbecue. Anyway, I had these people walk up to me that night, and they're like, "Oh, you're the kid that's always skateboarding in the parking lot. Wow, it's great to have you here. You're welcome anytime." I'm like, "Cool." They're like, "Jesus loves you and has a plan for your life." I'm like, "Whoever Jesus is, that's awesome, because I have no clue what I'm doing, even though I was 14, but I wanted to be a pro skater." Anyway, I started going to that church every Sunday morning, every Sunday night, every Wednesday evening for youth group. Anytime that we could hop in the church van and go to Pizza Inn and get free pizza, I was there. Every time that, the reason I had this part tonight for sure is because we played basketball earlier. You remember that? You guys did pretty good. I had nothing to do with winning. It was all Isaiah, straight up. Anyway, they would play what they call tag football in this lawn, and it always ended up in a game of rugby. Never once did someone not get hurt. I saw, this guy John, he was a track star of our high school. I saw him break his collarbone one night, and he's laying on the ground trying not to cry, and I'm like, "Whoa, what's going on?" And then one night, Sam, the starting center for the high school football team, he sprained his ankle really, really, really bad right before a big game on Friday. So his coach was mad too. But the thing that made it to where I knew I had to be around those people forever was, we were in that fellowship hall, the same one that I walked in and had the potluck a month before, right? And someone decided they were going to get a chair out, and they were going to run across the room and jump up and tag this part that hung down in the middle of the room to show off for the girls that were there. All of you dudes have done it at one point, whether it was at a church or not, doesn't matter. Anyway, he's jumping off this chair and he's tagging it. And then Mitch decides he's going to do it because Mitch plays on the football team. And he's going to jump really high. And then Chris does it too. Chris flies off of there. And Johnny, of course, that was who started it. He kind of just keeps going higher and higher and braver and more brave. Braver or what? And here comes Donnie. Donnie is Johnny's younger, better looking, much more athletic little brother, right? He just... Jordan's, it was incredible. So Johnny has one more effort that he's going to do, and he takes off running, and keep in mind I'm standing right here by the piano the whole time because I know something awesome is about to happen. Johnny flies off the chair goes out from under him, he is airborne, he's horizontal, and he's looking back, slow motion, it's like, it's just slow-mo. His arm hits the carpet first, right? And it just so happened that it was all red carpet in the fellowship hall, which I thought was awesome. His arm hits first, his elbow comes over and jams into his armpit, right? So it dislocates his elbow, he's laying on the ground, he's slobbering and gritting his teeth and trying not to cry in front of the girls, right? I'm like, no way, it's crazy! Your arm's crazy! You know, and so, the girls, there's like seven of them left at that point because a lot of them lost interest way early. They all go, and just walk out, right? And Johnny's laying there on the ground, suffering. I knew at that moment, I was like, I want to be around these people all the time. One, because I'm highly entertained by them. But another is like, they have loved me unconditionally the whole time that I've known them for the past month. Didn't care who I was, what I had done. And so I started going to church there, like I said, for a whole month. It took me a whole month before I decided that I wanted this Jesus, and I wanted to surrender my life to him. And I wanted to know what his plan was for my life. It wasn't until 5 years later when I was 19 years old that I came to realize what God's plan was, and that was to start a band and to do this and to be here tonight. And I can't imagine my life in any other way. I mean, there are times you have the thought of like, what would it be like really just to be able to be at home every night? You could actually make plans to do things, even short notice, because you're not going to be out of town for 3 weeks right off the bat. And that you never miss an episode of Shark Tank. You can sit on the couch every morning and drink a cup of coffee while your boys watch Hulk and the Agents of Smash. But it makes you treasure those moments even more. If there's something that you feel like God is telling you to do tonight and you're not doing it, ask yourself why. Maybe you're afraid. Maybe you're worried about how is God going to provide for you. I'm there all the time. I'm in a rock band. I have a wife, kids, a mortgage. But God wants you to trust him, and he wants you to be desperate for him at all times. And that's hard sometimes because you're like, man, can I just catch a break? I mean, just a break where you're not consistently thinking about where else can we tour this year, or who's going to book a show, or you're scouring Facebook, which I think is how this show came about. It's because of Facebook posting something. I'm glad it did. Glad it worked out. I believe in Jesus. I believe that he's the Son of God. He's exactly who he said he was. He's the Savior of the world. So thanks for being here. All the bands, thank you for being here too, because it's easy to show up and sometimes no one else shows up, just the bands. So it's an honor to be here. I'm gonna play one more song and then I'm gonna get out of your way. All the bands have merchandise if you're interested. But in those times that you're dealing with stuff, you wonder how you've made it as far as you have. It's because Jesus. It's because Jesus was carrying you. I recorded a worship record in January. If you're some of the people that got behind it, I'm sorry it's not done yet. But there's spoken CDs over there, random hero CDs. I think I have three ghetto burned CDs that have a couple of my worship tunes on it if you're interested. I also have some Matt Beard Tiger shirts. Tigers are sick. Thanks for being here. Thank you. to feel your touch, to see your smile. Jesus, won't you carry me forward? Whenever I'm lost in my dreams, you are there. You carry me. Thank you.